so it's not choosing difficulty. Interesting.
Out of the darkness they came with a hateful will to destroy humanity. We fought long and hard. Now we are lost. They have taken back even war into our hearts.
So this game's fucking awesome, and in like goddamn fucking third grade, I played this with my friend and his little brother, and I even brought over my little brother, and we all fucking played this game, and it was fucking amazing. So everybody's got it. All the people that I see still playing this game on fucking YouTube, they all have amazing stories like this. Like, played with my friends and my family, and this game's just fucking amazing, and everybody's got really good stories like that. And that's the really important thing with video games, is that this is just like really, really good shit, because these are real memories. It's not just a fucking game, and you can play this game. Like here, look. This is the fucking controller right here. You can play this game. It's not fake. It's real. It's a fucking simulation. It's better than any fucking movie you could ever watch. You feel things on a deeper level. People that don't play video games, they're just fucking missing out. And if you think people that are playing video games are weird, then you're a fucking idiot. You're just missing out on immersion. Video games in and of itself is immersion. Playing Wii games, that's just another level of immersion. VR, that's another level of immersion. The 3DS, that's another level of immersion. Yeah, I don't have any VR shit. I played it a couple times. It's cool, but the games were shit. They were not entertaining. And yeah, why Why do you not see anyone playing VR? Because it just never took off. VR is shit. And the problem with VR is, well, you could fucking stream it. You could fucking take out the fucking video and record it and shit. There's always a way to do that shit. So why don't you ever see anybody playing VR games? It's because they're shit. They don't fucking compare to this shit. This shit's the fucking shit. This is awesome. That shit's just shit. This is the shit. You gotta be playing this shit. This is Time Splitters 2 on the GameCube. Came out in like 2003 or some shit. Yeah. Fucking amazing. So much good shit. So much amazing, good fucking entertainment was created in the early 2000s. It is completely fucking mind-blowing how little good shit it has come out since then. It's fucking insane. Fucking Banjo-Tooie on the Nintendo 64 came out in 2000. It's fucking insane. Everything good in the world happened in like 5 fucking years. 2000 to 2005. It's fucking insane. So, can you not even... So, it's telling me to play the first level. Okay, there you go. Interesting. Interesting. Invisible guy. This is a team battle, but I forgot. I did pretty good. Talking about overkill. Oh yeah. Slick Tommy and Jimmy Needles. There's Slick Tommy. There's Jimmy Needles. It's like 30. That's like 32 fucking characters. You have 30 fucking characters off the fucking get-go. What kind of fucking game gives you 30 fucking characters when you start the game? And like fucking 70 when you're done. This game is fucking insane. This game is fucking insane. It gives you fucking high speed, low speed, fucking big ass, fucking hard ass, fucking low accuracy, high accuracy. It's fucking insane. Yeah, there you go. I always choose fucking fast characters. They're fucking fast and they're cool.
Ample sound. Nice. Oh, cool.
Yeah, I don't think you ever get anything for playing the regular modes, which is kind of sad. So it's not like Smash Bros. At all. It's fucking so much better. This is a real fucking game. This is what the fucking men play.
Whoa, yeah. Thank you.
I don't even know where the fucking base is. Oops. How do I get upstairs? How the fuck do I get upstairs? Dance, bitch, dance. There you go. Found it.
There's my base. Oh shit, look at that. That's fine.